Join host Kel Mitchell for an exclusive sneak peek at Pokémon The Movie 2000, featuring the newest mythical Pokémon and performances from Pokémon soundtrack artists. Plus, appearances by Christina Aguilera and NSYNC. The Power of One, the Pokémon 2000 movie special, right on the new WB Sunday.
Hollywood, it's the premiere of Pokémon The Movie 2000. Please welcome Youngstown, featuring Nobody's Angel.
So you want to be the master of Pokemon, understand the secrets and have some fun. So you want to be the master of Pokemon, do you have the skills to be number one?
Number one!
Let's do it. I want to check the ultimate step and find the courage to be bold, yeah. To risk it all and not forget the lessons that I hold, yeah. To learn the way to take command,
use the power that's in my hand. We all live in the Pokemon
world.
I wanna be the best
master of them all.
We all live in the Pokemon world.
Put myself to the test, be better than all the rest.
Oh, yeah.
So you wanna be a master of
tonight on The Power of One, the Pokémon 2000 movie special, Secrets of Pokémon The Movie 2000. Ash Ketchum, Pikachu, Misty, Team Rocket, and the never-before-seen new characters making their debut in the movie. Plus, appearances by NSYNC, Christina Aguilera, Kobe Bryant, Seventh Heaven's David Gallagher. And we'll take you behind the scenes with Donna Summer, Weird Al Yankovic, and the other stars of the Pokemon soundtrack as they record the album. You'll meet a 12-year-old girl with a dream that took her from her small-town home to Hollywood and a shot at stardom. Plus, a live performance from Dream Street, all tonight. And now your host, from Keenan and Kel, and this summer's The Adventures of Rocky and Bullwinkle, Kel Mitchell.
Oh, here we go! What's the hell? Hey! Woo! Yeah! Hey, welcome to The Power of One, the Pokemon 2000 movie special, celebrating the power of each and every one of us to make a difference. Woo! Hey, hey. Everyone's talking about Pokemon The Movie 2000, the story, the music, and most of all, the exciting new characters. This premiere is the biggest thing going on in Hollywood today. And no wonder, the stars are here, the bands are here, even the Pokemon are here. Give it up for Pokemon! Pika Pika! Pikachu! They're all here to get an early look at Pokemon The Movie 2000. In Pokemon The Movie 2000, the forces of nature are thrown out of balance, threatened to destroy the Earth. It's down to one person to make all the difference and save the world. Check it out.
Well, what are we waiting for?
In the movie, Ash Ketchum, Pokemon trainer, finds himself in the middle of a crisis like none before.
Experts now believe that the weather disasters occurring in all parts of the globe are due to a powerful and previously unknown phenomenon from
the legend. Could it be?
Far from home, on a tranquil sea at Shamoody Island, Ash and friends find themselves cast in an ancient legend come to life.
Hey, what's this? Disturb not the harmony of fire, ice, or lightning.
Lest these titans wreak destruction upon the world in which they clash.
With these powerful forces threatening the world's very existence, can one person really make a difference?
He's always the hero.
We're always a zero.
What can I do that somebody else can't?
The choice is yours. You must go only where your heart leads.
With the fate of the Earth at stake, Ash must summon the strength that lies within us all. The power to make a difference. The power of one.
Hey, in this cool Pokemon The Movie 2000 opens across America on July 21st. And this Pokemon premiere is just cranking up. So don't even think about touching that dial. Don't you go nowhere. Don't go nowhere. Come back. Come back to me. Come back to me.
Still to come, even more secrets from Pokemon The Movie 2000. From Donna Summer to Weird Al, we're behind the scenes for the making of the Pokemon 2000 soundtrack. And Seventh Heaven's David Gallagher joins Kel. All coming up. Who's that Pokemon? Find out when we come back on The Power of One, the Pokemon 2000 movie special.
The Power of One, the Pokemon 2000 movie special is brought to you in part by...
Welcome back to The Power of One, the Pokemon 2000 movie special. Who's that Pokemon? It's Elekid, a brand new character who makes its debut in Pikachu's Rescue Adventure, the bonus mini-movie you can only see at Pokemon The Movie 2000.
From Pokemon The Movie 2000 a little later in the show, but now I want you to meet a friend of mine whose name is well known from the WB's Seventh Heaven. Here's David Gallagher! Hey, what's up, David? Thanks for coming here.
No problem. Thanks for inviting me, man. This is so cool. Hey, Pokemon rules!
Yeah! Hey, so what does the theme Power of One mean to you?
Well, to me, it means that each and every one of us have the power to make a difference.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. And hey, all you have to do is get involved.
That's right.
There are a lot of kids all over America who are doing just that.
We're going to meet a few right now, along with some special guests who know how important it is to make a difference.
Corey and Brock Snyder made a difference by raising $25,000 so their fire department could afford goggles that help firefighters see through smoke. Gabriella Contreras has been making a difference since she was in the third grade, organizing peace marches and working to end violence and drug abuse in her school.
I think it's important that young people today realize that they really do have the power to change the world.
Andre Graves turned his life around when he stopped selling drugs. Now he's making a difference by helping other kids stay on the right path.
I think kids need to know that no matter how old you are, if you're 10, if you're 7, if you're 14 or 16, that you have a voice, and that if you are passionate, if you are committed, and if you really, really believe in something and you want to change something, then you can do that.
Diana, Crystal, and Trevor want to change something. These elementary school students became worried a year ago when Diana's mom was sent to the hospital with a life-threatening disease called lupus.
It was really sad, and I didn't know if I could get through it.
Diana turned to her friend Crystal, and together, they talked about the problem.
We were really scared, so we wanted to do something to help.
Me and my sister found two round rocks, and then we came to Mom and asked her what we should do with them.
The kids painted the rocks so they would look like ladybugs.
And then we decided that we should sell them, make to raise money for lupus.
I felt really glad when they said that, because then I knew that it would help my mom. And then when we started doing the project, it really helped other people too.
When we talked about it, we talked about lucky ladybugs for lupus, because when I grew up, ladybugs were lucky. If they landed on your shoulder or something like that, it was a sign of good luck.
The kids took the ladybugs to stores, and they were a big success.
We thought we were going to raise $1,000. We didn't think it was going to be in a short time. We thought it was going to take a while. But it took only 4 months.
Now that it's been a whole year, the rocks have rolled in more than $12,000.
And it just warms my heart to know that three kids cared enough to want to do something, not only to help me, but to make people aware that that lupus is real.
Although Diana's mom isn't cured, she's out of the hospital and feeling a lot better.
I think a normal person can make a difference if they just put their mind to it.
Just goes to show that you don't have to have a huge idea to do something. It's a small, it comes from your heart. And I believe that this came from the kid's heart.
These young people are all winners. I think a real champion is someone who uses what they have to help others. You don't have to be rich. You don't have to be famous. You just have to be motivated. Spend the time, make the effort. One person really can make all the difference.
Great job, everybody. Here are five guys you might recognize who understand the importance of making a difference.
We founded Challenge for the Children to raise money for children's programs and charities.
And our Challenge for the Children 2 will be held in New York City, so we hope to see you there.
It all happens July 28th and 29th.
Because we believe in making a difference. So take the time to get involved in something you believe in.
The power of one is in you, too.
Yeah. Hey, now, if you or someone you know is making a difference, we want to know about it. Clue us in at the Pokémon movie website, p2kthemovie.com. That's also the place you can find out more about the young people you just met and the projects they're involved in. Hey, thanks, David. We'll see you on Seventh Heaven.
All right.
All right, man. Yeah. Hey, give it up for David Gallagher. In Pokémon, Ash pursues his dream to become a Pokémon master. Here's a story about a girl who's also pursuing her dream.
Only a few months ago, Alicia Antonino was a small-town girl who loved to sing. But now, the 12-year-old is the toast of a Hollywood premiere. Alicia's come a long way in a short time.
Hello.
Back home just a few months ago, Alicia could only dream of being a star.
When I was little, I set a goal to become a famous singer like Celine Dion.
Every time we get in the car, she loves to sing. You hear her singing everywhere.
The first time I've ever sang in my life, it was at this competition thing when I was 7.
But lightning didn't strike until Mom entered her in an internet singing competition. And that's when superstar songwriter Carol Bayer Sager heard her voice.
Until she was 12 years old, and I went, this isn't hardly possible.
Suddenly, the small-town girl was making it big. Alicia got a chance to record with Carol and two of the biggest names in the business, Kenny Babyface Edmonds and Celine Dion's producer, David Foster. And speaking of Celine...
Alicia!
Hi!
You're wonderful! Oh my God, you go, girl!
Oh, thank you! All of a sudden, I start hearing a voice, I'm all like, oh my God, that's Celine Dion!
Okay.
Oh my God.
Celine's not Alicia's only big fan. The star makers at Atlantic Records chose her to be part of the Pokémon 2000 soundtrack and even invited her to perform at the premiere.
I can't wait. I've been working on my show and everything, and I can't wait.
Hey, the wait is over. Here's Alicia!
There's no man.
Just ahead on the Power of One, the Pokémon 2000 movie special, Dream Street performs live on stage, and your all-access pass gets you in the studio for a special behind-the-scenes look at the making of the Pokémon 2000 soundtrack with Nobody's Angel, Weird Al, and Donna Summer. Who's that Pokémon? Find out when we come back on the Power of One, the Pokémon 2000 movie special. Welcome back to the Power of One, the Pokémon 2000 movie special. Who's that Pokémon? It's the legendary Lugia, a mysterious and powerful creature that makes its first appearance ever in Pokémon The Movie 2000 and helps Ash in his quest to make a difference.
Cut it out!
The great guardian, Lugia.
I can't believe it. Lugia?
Hey! Woo, what's up? The soundtrack from the first Pokémon movie was a huge hit. I've heard the new one, and I'm sure it'll be even bigger. Right now, we're going to take you guys inside the studio where Donna Summer and the other stars recorded the P2K soundtrack album. Check it out, y'all. Come on.
A friend of mine called me and said, you've got to hear this song. I think this is a perfect song for you. It's going to be in the new Pokemon. And I used to say Pokemon, and my kids used to say, no, Mom, it's Pokemon.
The amazing Donna Summer is just one of the great artists to perform on the soundtrack for Pokemon The Movie 2000. She's joined by Nobody's Angel in Youngstown, the B-52s, supergroup Westlife, Weird Al Yankovic, and the boys from Plus One.
Totally awesome. So many great people on the soundtrack.
The incomparable Weird Al Yankovic brings his unique talent to bear on the tongue-twisting Pokemon track.
I don't think there's going to be any other polkas on the soundtrack. I don't think there is. You know, the root of all music is polka.
You'll also hear the hit-making B-52s turn up the volume for The Chosen One. But the soul of the soundtrack and the real vocal fireworks come from the legendary Donna Summer.
I like singing positive songs. I like songs that make people happy. I like songs that encourage people to do great things.
It's inside of you with me. Each of us holds the key to the power of one.
Hey, making their television debut with a song from the P2K soundtrack, here's Dream Street!
Oh, they don't understand. They say we're just playing games, that it isn't real. But that's what we feel, oh yeah. And they say it doesn't make sense, that we're just wasting time. And they wonder why. You know we got
Pokemon.
Hey, everybody, thanks for coming to our premiere. Remember, there's power in the power of one. One person can make all the difference. At home, in school, in your town, wherever you are, you can make a difference. Pokémon The Movie 2000 opens all across America on Friday, July 21st. So get there early. I've seen it. You're going to love the cool new Pokémon. The story is amazing, and the music and the action will blow you away on the big screen. Check it out. I'm out of here, y'all. Power One, Pokémon!
To the best people.